Hey everyone, I'm Aaron. I just wanted to make a video real quick to try to help some people that might be struggling with this or just curious about how certain parts of the lab might be done. This is lab four, should be the one we're doing currently. But yeah, so the first part here is pretty self-explanatory. We're moving these integers into our values. So basically, straight from here, not too much going on there. But when it comes to finding this if statement and then the absolute value, that's when it gets a little tricky. So the move function, they wanted us to use move s instead of a comparison. So how I did that, I used a temporary variable. So basically, r1 is going to go into r6. And so the basically R6 is like our testing variable. The S here, what that means is I'm gonna test whatever's in our first position and compare that to zero. That's all it means is comparison. It doesn't say less than greater than, it just says, hey, I'm gonna compare this variable to zero. And then what we're gonna do with that, so that's like our if statement sort of. We're going to do this R3 equals only if this variable is less than zero. So that's why we have this less than here. This less than says, with this comparison above R6 to zero, we're going to say R6 is less than zero. If so, do this statement. So RSB, that's your same as your sub, but that's its reverse sub. So meaning it's going to do this one minus that one. So 0 minus R6, and it's going to plop that into R3. So that gives us, if R1 is less than 0, R3 becomes the absolute value. In this case, it's 0 minus R6, so it's really not absolute value, but we already know R1 is less than 0. So 0 minus R1 is going to get a positive R1. So it works out in this case. So it's not really true absolute value, because if I did input a positive number, I would get a negative number from doing this. But we're just assuming the number inputted is negative already. Anyways, we're going to do the same thing here. I use R6 as our temporary variable, since it's temporary and we're done using it here, we can start using it again here. We're going to move R2 into it. So now we're comparing R6 to 0, and R6 is the same as R2 at the moment. So 0 minus R6 is going to be our R4. Alright, so now we're moving on to this. So this if statement here. So now we're allowed to use the comparison variable. It doesn't say we can't, so might as well. So we're going to compare R3 and R4. So if R3. Oh, and this is a mistake. This is supposed to be if R3 is less than or equal to R4. It says that right here. If R3 is less than or equal to R4. So that's a little mistake on the TA's part there. If it's less than or equal to 4, then it's going to go into this for loop here. But let's look at first the case that it's false. So if it's greater than, if R3 is greater than R4, then we want to skip this entire thing. So I made a branch for if it's greater than, and so that's going to go down to exit. It's just going to end. So that's basically going to go to else, and it's going to return 0. But in this case, this whole else statement is useless. So it's the same as if there isn't an else. So basically, I'm going from here straight down to here. If that's not the case, and if it's less than or equal to, basically, well, there's nothing, we don't have to check if it's less than or equal to, it's just going to keep on going to the next line. So here's where our for loop starts. Our for loop, in general, it's going to execute this first, then it's going to test this, run this, and then increment. Test, run, increment. Test, run, increment. So in a loop, until this is false, and then it's going to exit the loop, and then pretty much go to return 0. So to get this first one, I did this before the for loop. So it's going to set R6. R6 is our temporary variable, so we're making that n, basically. N is equal to R6. And then, so basically we're setting R3 to R6. Or, you know, the other way, R6 to R3. and then we enter the loop. So the first thing the loop's doing is comparing our R6, our n, to R4. And that comparison is a less than or equal to. So if it's greater than, we need to leave the loop. So that's what this is saying. If it's greater than, branch off to exit, since exit's basically the same thing if we had exited starting here. So might as well go to the same place, is what I'm saying. So now that we've left, we're fine. But if it's less than, it's going to just ignore this, and it's going to keep on moving. I mean, so you'll notice that basically the testing to get rid of, to leave the current thing and move on, like basically to skip, that's all the inverse of the test. So since the test is less than or equal to, we're doing greater than to get out of it. And then this is all just computing R5. I used another temporary variable, R7, set it to 60. So it's basically moving 60 into R7. And then I'm subtracting R7 from R6. R6 we determined was in. So I just did that twice. I don't know if there's a more efficient way to do this, but it seemed the most efficient way to me. With the knowledge I know, like, I don't know any other way to do it at the moment. And then we're going to go to add. So that's adding your R3 and your R4. So in the end, it should look like this. R7, our temporary variable, is this whole mess here. And then at the end, we're going to add R5. Basically, we're going to plus equals. So R5 equals plus... R5 equals R5 plus R7. So R5 plus this. And then now we need to increment. So we increment R6 by 1. Then we loop. So basically it's going to go back to the top. It's going to compare again. Since R6 has changed, we need to compare it again. And then it's going to test. If it's greater than, leave. So, you know, it's just going to keep running, loop, run, loop, run, loop, until R4, until R6 is greater than R4, and it's going to leave. So let's run it. I'm going to... I lost the last little bit of it. When I hit the run key, it stopped my recording, because that's the shortcut I use for stopping recording. Okay, so we're about to run it. So let's go and do that.
Sorry.
Excuse my computer making those weird noises. I put in some Portal 2 voice lines from the turrets as some of my computer sounds. I just thought it'd be funny. Alright, so the first part's pretty simple. Setting the variables. So we can see R1 and R2 is set. These look like big negative numbers. You know, obviously I can't really tell right off the bat, but I'm pretty sure negative 6, negative 18, so those are fine. All these are 0. Alright, so the first thing we're doing, we're checking if R1 is less than 0. So R6 is kind of our temporary variable for that. R6 is now what R1 was. And so, since it's true, R6 is less than 0, then it's going to run this code. And basically just going to do 0 minus this number. So R3 should become positive 6, and it does. Very nice. So same here, this will become positive 18, or 12 in hex. Alright, now we're comparing this variable. So, let's see where we at. Right here, right? So R3 and R4 is what we're comparing. So if it's less than, it should just skip this. So R3 is 6, R4 is 12, or 18 in hex. Or 12 in hex, 18 in decimal. So it's not less than, so it should just skip right past this. Now we're inside our for loop. So we're gonna run our temporary variable R6 as our R3. Now we're inside the for. Now we're comparing this right away. It's not less than R4, so it should just skip it, and it does. R6 being over here. So R6 basically is our counter variable, and we'll keep an eye on that one. And it's going to do all this math for R7. I'm just going to skip over that one. But then it's going to add into R5. So we have R5 here. We're going to plus equals it, basically. Now here we go. We're increasing our counter here by 1. So this should go to 7. Boom. Back into the loop. 6 and 4. So 6 is 7 and 4 is 18. So basically it's still less than, so it's going to go into our loop again. And see, R6 is now 8, so it's basically going to keep going through our loop. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, okay, 16, 17, 18. Okay, so this is the loop where it's where they're equal to each other, so it's still not greater than, because it needs to be less than or equal to, so we're fine. So it's going to keep going for one more loop. Now it's 13. Now it's greater than, basically our temporary variable in is greater than R4. And since it's greater than, we're going to exit. And it exits, so we're good. I do hope that helped some of y'all, and I can't prove that my code is 100% correct, so if you do find any errors, please let me know. But hopefully that helps anyone that was having trouble or maybe just needed like a reference. Please don't just like straight up copy, but I know some people are. That's fine though. Anyways, y'all have a nice day, and yeah, bye.